Namaste YouTube, welcome to Wuhan Coronavirus Lockdown Fest, and we are going to react to the reason of HOOBASTANK. It's a request, Patreon request, as well as part of our Wuhan Coronavirus Lockdown Fest. So let's get started with the music. I am listening to it for the first time ever in my life.
Even me. I'm not sure if I've heard it. It sounds familiar, the title, The Reason.
The Reason.
But I don't think I've ever heard HOOBASTANK before. So, as of now, it's a first time single take, pure, raw, unscripted, impromptu, spontaneous and honest reaction by Kirti and me.
Yeah.
During the Wuhan Coronavirus Lockdown Fest, we may have to change the name of the Wuhan Coronavirus Lockdown Fest to possibly New York Virus Lockdown Fest. Let's get started. HOOBASTANK, The Reason.
How much I appreciate the lyrics of this song.
Yeah, it talks about such important topics in there. Two main topics that touched my heart while listening to this song for the first time was, one was the fact that he's apologizing for whatever he did to hurt her, to harm her, to treat her the wrong way possibly. He's apologizing, he's kind of realized he did it wrong. And two, he's now a new person, he's a changed man. Because of that experience, because of how things went, it's just changed. So they are wonderful two topics which a lot of the world can learn from, especially those parts of the world, specifically countries such as America, UK, some cities in India, some cities in other parts of the world, could learn a lot from this song, because we end relationships so abruptly, so incorrectly, so aggressively. And it's just so bad. The statistics are so bad. Nearly 2 out of 3 relationships, long-term relationships such as marriages, ends up in ending. If it's a marriage, it ends up in the divorce courts. How sad is that? And why does it happen that way? Because we don't learn our lessons along the way. There might be other reasons, but the main thing is that if something's not working, there must be a time when you sit down and meditate and reflect on why things aren't working. You either do it alone and preferably do it with your partner, but you need to sit down and work it out. But that's what people don't like doing. There are many places in the West, specifically where I have clients from, who think counseling, going to a counselor is actually bad. That, oh, there's something wrong with us. There's something wrong with us if we go to a counselor for marital help or relationship help. Something wrong. I should not go to a counselor. They're only here to eat up our money. They're not there to help us. They're always bad apples in every bunch. But overall, you see 98 to 99% of the time, counselors are there to help you. You need an outsider's perspective on things. You need someone to listen to you and in turn put things in perspective for you. And this has possibly happened with him. Maybe through meditation, maybe through intervention, maybe through some other means. But he's realized things, and I love the way it is worded. It is kind of repetitive. I would have liked a verse or two which was unique, because that would have made this a masterpiece. But right now, as it is, I wouldn't call it a masterpiece, but it's really good.
It is a good song. We don't need a reason to wake up from a nightmare. We just need to wake up. There is no reason required for you to stop horrific things that turn your life into a nightmare. You just need to open your eyes, wake up, and get going. That's all I have to say.